So about the PHP user group, in the beginning, as with all good stories, in the beginning, well, actually, some good stories, some other good stories to start with a long, long time ago. Yeah, but anyway. So in the beginning, as a load developer in my company, I was basically feeling a strain of actually working alone, as a lot of you developers right now probably feel that way, some of you. Those who are more fortunate are probably working in a team. So I was kind of like that in your position, all alone, and I really wanted a support group, a team, a group of people I can share about my pains, all my FMLs and all that stuff, and even to share some victories and even share some knowledge about what and basically how I can become better at our craft. Because I think as a software engineer, I really want to be as good as I can be and deliver the best product I can for my, for clients and for the people that I'm working for. So I really wanted to have a support group for all people I can meet together with. I heard of these similar concepts being used by other groups. This concept called user group. Kind of like, so there were two groups that are around at the time, the Singapore Java user group, which I've heard of but never actually met anyone. Actually just met someone recently, but they probably disbanded right now. And the other one is the Singapore Ruby Brigade. We think nowadays they just don't go by Ruby SG. So yeah, these are two groups that were there back in 2007. So I thought it would be a good idea to kind of like try and start something on my own. So I did some Googling around and trying to figure out whether there's any existing user groups in PHP, because I was doing PHP at the time, so I really want to know other developers who are doing PHP as well. As it turns out, there were, but we're not the first PHP user group in Singapore. There were two other earlier efforts, and by the end of 2006, they were both inactive, as in no longer. I couldn't even contact the person that was running those groups before. So I thought, okay, you know, no one's doing this now. Why don't I just try something on my own? So I created a user group on meetup.com, which I thought was a cool idea. You know, meetup.com is a website you can go and discover and meet people, like-minded people of interest groups and stuff. So I thought programming is an interest of mine, so I should start an interest group for PHP developers. So I did that in December 2006. I organized my first meetup on 11th of Jan, which is 10 years from this day. And I did the first meetup at Brewworks, because I kind of like, you know, I don't have any technical things to talk about, but it's interest group, right? I think beer is a very... beer is a good way to get people talking and meeting together. So I thought it would be a good idea to meet people for beer, programmers like me, you know, who probably hopefully has free time on a weekday night. Turns out not many people show up. So I was a bit sad. About five of us sitting at Brewworks, ordering some good food and having some nice chit-chat. It was interesting. My regret was I didn't take a photo to memorialize the moment because I couldn't find anything, and my Facebook account was created in 2007, so I couldn't find any photos mid 2007, so I couldn't find any photos way back from early 2007. So, unfortunately, so from that quiet beginning, that's where we started. This is how it looked like the page. Of course, it doesn't look like this. Back then, we didn't have that folder up there. So you can see here, January 11, 2007 at Brewworks. At the time, I was the CTO of a small media digital agency called Comworks. So I was like, hey, you know, meet people, but only five show up. So there were like, how many RSVP? There was, I don't know, there was like 20 people who RSVP'd, but four or five people show up. So it was okay. So as I said, there were no traction, not many people came, and there were many, many months after that. I tried to do one in February, March, because in the early days when you started a meetup.com group, they will try to tell you to fix a day in the month to organize a meetup, and they will automatically create a meetup for you, you know, in the past. So it will force you to have a meetup. I don't know, it was free back then. I don't think it was any cost involved. So anyway, so I created... Okay, right. You created one in February. It just kind of duplicated the first month's description to the second month, and I, okay, fine. So there was many months where I tried to have a whole more meetup, so I just couldn't find people. I think, basically there wasn't much awareness about it. I didn't know where to go and to tell people about it. But fortunately for me, in 2007, the tech startup scene was actually getting started, as in a lot of people coming from the Valley, especially students from universities. Of note is a group of students who went through the NOC program, NUS Overseas College Program. So a lot of them came back from the Valley, and they were like, "Hey, we want to bring the startup culture into Singapore." And from there, I joined a couple of their meetings, and I got in contact with a lot of people. And in 2007, October, there were one of the groups, E27, they're still around. Back then, they were called Entrepreneur 27. So you can check out their website. I think it's still there. So if you Google for Facebook Developer Garage, you'll find a mention of it way back in 2007, 24th October. Their blog was running then. The photos are no longer there, but it's still there. So I can find the page. That's how I remember the date, actually. So anyway, so I thought to myself, hey, since around that time when Facebook first opened up their API. So then Facebook had an SDK, an API, and the Graph API, where you can talk to the Facebook data and get all the stuff there. It was around the time when they started launching that, and you can build games on it. That was when the E27 did this Facebook Developer Garage to kind of like bring together game developers who were working on the Facebook platform. So I thought it would be a good avenue to kind of like tell people about, hey, the PHP user group exists, can come meet me. What I did was I created a Facebook group for the Singapore PHP user group, and also printed some name cards which I kind of gave out at the end of the Facebook Developer Garage. So I made an announcement there, and the membership in the Facebook group just skyrocketed. It's like we were like a few hundred people joining the group. Today we have about 3,000 members on our Facebook group. I believe half of them are bots. But still a good number.
At least they use the Facebook API to get that done.
Yeah. There you go. So I thought, hey, it'd be a good idea to kind of like do another meetup again. So I tried to organize one in November. This time, instead of using meetup.com, I used facebook.com to kind of like create a Facebook event. Of course, I also created a meetup.com event and a Facebook event at the same time. So I thought, you know, maybe I can compare the number of people who RSVP'd who actually showed up. So it turns out, when I created the event, I was kind of like half joking. I wasn't really sure I could actually get enough people to come, because I had so many months of disappointment where I tried to organize but no one came. So I was like, I don't need a venue now, I just put it up there first, then it says to be confirmed or something like that. So I created the event, there was no venue, the RSVP number just hit skyrocketed, about 40 people RSVP'd. I was like, whoa, okay, we have a lot of people coming. I think we need a place. But we don't have one yet. Right. Small panic. So fortunately for me, I have friends. As I mentioned earlier, there were other user groups around. And Singapore Ruby Brigade was one of those that was around. I kind of like asked them, hey, you guys organized a meetup at SMU, right? So could you guys introduce me to somebody who I can talk to and maybe get a place? So Mr. Li Yaolong, who is a lecturer at the School of Infosystems at SMU, he introduced me to the Object Oriented Programming Society in SMU. It is a real society. What the student groups there? I think they may have changed their name, I don't know whether they're still around, but I think. But there is a group. There is a whole society created to learn about object oriented programming, stuff that we take for granted nowadays. Anyway, so I thought great, we have people who are willing to come, and we have a venue, so now I need to find speakers. So I was thinking, since it's the first one, there's so many people, I should speak, so I should talk a bit about something, I can't remember what. Oh yeah, I thought I was talking about, Okay, so basically I wanted to, from my experience and probably my intuitive understanding of the community, I felt we should have topics that cater to three groups of people. The first group are beginners, people who are new to PHP. Second group are people who are professionals, who have been doing PHP for a while. And also business folks, people who are kind of like on the lookout for PHP people to hire. Right, so I basically found people who were able to talk on three things. So this is the brochure I prepared, kind of cheesy, but yeah. So basically I spoke about PHP 101, and we got this guy, Raymond Ng, he was talking about, Alan? Yeah. So we got this Raymond who will talk a little bit about how PHP and how is PHP and your business, how you can use open source technologies and stuff. And we had Yuzin Chua, who talked to us a little bit about security in PHP. Yuzin was a student which I kind of hired for on a part time during one of his term breaks, and he went on to do other things. And he basically runs a blogging platform called ping.sg, and also at the time he was CTO of a small company called Widges, small startup which was I think iGEM funded. Which is kind of cool. Anyway, so there were three of us. We were basically, you know, first meet up at SMU. It was in November 2007. And this is us. Hand wavy stuff. Are the photos clear?
Yes.
Okay, okay. So three hand wavy stuff. You can see a lot of my gestures there, doing this and that. There was me back in the day, 10 years ago. And that's me with the V sign. So I'm hurt right now. This V sign is a bad thing. So because people can take photos of it and get like my thumbprint and... I think it's too low grade to get anything from there. So yeah, I think it's pretty safe. So I actually had stickers printed back then. You can see the color, the blue stickers, green stickers, and yellow stickers to kind of like designate, are you a beginner? Or are you looking for, are you a newbie? Are you a professional? Or are you like an entrepreneur or business folks looking for? It's kind of like a way, informal way of getting people to start a conversation with each other, which I felt was important to get people talking to each other. And we have some more photos of the attendees. Shen Heng, I think you can see a photo there when you had long hair. Thank yeah, you. Over there. Yeah. And this.
Did you have any longer hair?
Did I have longer hair? Yes, I think I did have a bit more hair back then. I believe I had more hair back then. And I used to wear shirts. Anyway, so I had a good fortune in the early days to have bloggers who attend our meetups. And a lot of them were doing live blogging as we were talking about stuff. And we had blogger friends who were really into photography, and they took a lot of photos for me. And they came up with a little comic strip to tell me about how I am gesturing and all that stuff. So hopefully I don't do that much of that anymore. Hopefully. Anyway, so as I said, so I experimented with the format. Because in the first meetup, we had three speakers. By the time all three speakers finished, we ended up about 10 o'clock, which is kind of late. So no, I think we should try and manage this a bit. So we thought in the second meetup, we should try experiment. And what we did was we broke it into two tracks. So there were two tracks, two rooms happening simultaneously. And we have four speakers on that day. So that was on the second meetup. And there was also some problem with the venue, because back in those days, SMU actually, during the term break, it was December holidays, so they're having a term break and the aircon turns off at 7 o'clock, which is about the start time of our meetup. So I thought, oh shit, we can't use SMU anymore. But fortunately, through our friends in E27, they got us a place at NUS Extension, which is at Park Mall. It's kind of like NUS's, NUS had a campus for adult programs, postgrad programs in the city near Dhoby Ghaut MRT. So they had a facility there, which is kind of nice. So this is how it looks like. It's a pretty big room. Yeah. And you can see here photos of the speakers. Where's Lester? Over there. So this is first time Lester spoke at one of our meetups. He was talking about building WordPress extensions, if I'm not wrong. Was it? You guess so, I can't remember. Yeah. So I was introduced to him and he was like, oh, he's one of the most prolific, well-known WordPress extension builders in Singapore. Like, okay, sure, we should try and get him to talk. And yeah, he was still in university, if I'm not wrong, second year, right? first or second year?
Second year,
yes. Big size. So anyway, and also it was that at that meetup we also had the first engagement with a corporate, as in a company, which is which was surprise for me. It was a very surprising introduction. On the left, you see this person. His name is Chris Ishmael. At the time, he was working at Microsoft as Microsoft Singapore as part of the developer evangelist team. And he was a PHP programmer back in the Philippines. So when he came to Singapore and he joined Microsoft, he was actually at the Facebook Developer Garage, and he came up to me, "Hey, look, I really like what you're doing. I want to speak at your meetups and stuff." So he came and spoke at our second meetup, and on that day he gave a demo on how Windows Server 2008 running headless could he installed WordPress. IIS and WordPress, and he did it in one sitting, as in during the talk. At the beginning of his talk, he started installation. At the end of the talk, about half an hour later, he had a Windows Server 2008 running headless, IIS and WordPress running on it, MySQL, I believe. So it was pretty cool. We also had another friend from Indonesia, bottom right. His name is Rama Yurindra. He was basically part of the PHP user group in Indonesia, and he also runs. He also represents Zen Technologies in this part of the world. I guess you all know what Zen Technologies is, right? Zen engine, Zen certified engineer certification, stuff like that. Okay, yeah. So basically, he represents them in this part of the world at the time. So he also came to Singapore and gave a talk there. On the left, we also have another guy from Microsoft. His name is Matthew Hartman. Also, he and Chris Ishmael basically like did a tag team and gave a whole talk about how you could run PHP on the Windows platform. For me, it was an interesting departure. I've been so familiar with open source technologies, and suddenly we have a company that prides itself in writing proprietary software, saying we want to embrace open source, which for me was a very big departure from what I understand of these kind of companies. And for them, it's a case of I rather have half a part of the pie rather than the whole pie, right? As in, I want to get more people involved into the Microsoft ecosystem somehow, right? So it's kind of interesting. And yes, we had women back then. We had women in PHP meetup, which we have more right now, which is cool. Anyway, but running two-track meetups is hard because we have people who want to be in the other track and everything. So it's like, this is not going to work. So we revert back to a single-track meetup. And instead of having three speakers, we just had two speakers. We want to cater to both the beginners and the professionals. And for business folks, we basically felt that they can take care of themselves, right? Because as long as you give them opportunities to network with people in the meetup, they should be able to find people and talk to people and be able to basically potentially hire some of the people who's in the group. So we gave them a lot of opportunities for networking, like tea breaks and food and pizza, like what we have right now in the beginning parts. We have food so that you all get to network and hopefully meet people. And then of course, then we have technical talks. In March of the year, we organized a second Facebook Developer Garage, because E27 wasn't going to run another one. We kind of like say we want to help you with this. So we ran a second Facebook Developer Garage here in Microsoft at this place. We had two tracks, and we had panelists who basically were kind of like already building stuff on the Facebook platform. We also had students from NUS who were running. Who were part of Ben Leong's class, and they were basically writing Facebook games as part of their coursework. Some of you may recognize the lady on the left. She's Su Yuan. She basically runs Momo Central. This is when 10 years ago when she was still an undergrad in NUS. And the guy on the right in the middle. I forgot his name, but he's one of the co-founders of Nitrous.io. Yeah, so it's kind of cool.
Peter Kim.
Peter Kim, yes, correct. Peter Kim, he was also at Viki for a time. Anyway, yep. And yeah, this is how big the group is. I also felt that being PHP developers, we shouldn't just be looking at our own ecosystem. We should also try to look outside to get exposed to how other people are doing things. So I brought in my friends who were Rubyists and Pythonistas, and we basically got them to talk a bit more about Ruby on Rails and Python, Django, and how those frameworks do things so that we can get a better idea. And yes, that is that's our colleague. I think his profile picture, this is still his profile picture, right? Alan?
Yeah. I don't know how many
like also, further on that year, we had a meetup at Yahoo. Again, Chris on the left. This is the first time we felt it was important to also get involved, get more PHP companies involved. And basically, at the time, Yahoo was probably one of the most prominent, one of the other prominent company out there that uses PHP. We also had a lot of students. This is the first, this meetup at Yahoo, we actually had students coming from NUS High, and their teacher basically brought them here to kind of meet people in the industry. You will notice the second guy on the left, his name is Vishnu, who is right now at NUS, in NUS. I think he's part of NUS Hackers. He's one of the members there. So this is the first time I met him. Yeah. Of course, we also, it was important for me that the community can grow. And for me, one of the ways I thought we could figure this out was to have certification programs. So I started a small little school to kind of like teach and run PHP certification courses. We also had meetups in other places, Oracle. Of course, unfortunately, that certification class didn't last very long, about 2 years. I think it ran for about 1 or 2 years. It was, but each of the course was about three, four weekends. I did the last one probably in April. And I took a small hiatus from then. Basically, at the time, I joined a startup. Like many people at the time, we joined a startup, and startup life is hard, since it's very, takes out a lot of your time. But in 2012, when I joined another startup, a bigger startup, Make33, and basically, Alan, sorry, yeah. So I joined another startup in 2012, and where I had more, a little bit more time, so I started doing more meetups again. At the time, you know, when I first started doing meetups, I have three focus groups: beginners, professionals, and then business folks. Then I thought, you know, developers, I shouldn't just clump you guys into beginners and professionals and whatnot, because we're all developers, right? So why we want to focus on how to make us better web developers, because most PHP work is on building web applications. So I thought we should focus more on web applications and web development, how you can make you guys better web developers. We should not just, so we don't restrict ourselves just PHP, but other areas like JavaScript, web technologies, and so on and so forth. I also started doing some basic workshops back then. And of course, in 2014, we basically hosted Matt Manowak, one of the co-founders of Automattic and also one of the creators of WordPress. So a bunch of us. Lester, this is you again.
Yeah.
Yay! Yeah, so we had a lot of people again in this space. So this is the organizing team that was kind of like putting this whole thing together, which is kind of, to me, was a very impressive thing, because we only had very short time to do this. I remember it was only about 1 or 2 weeks, or very short time, very short notice. But we managed to pull it together. We even did a podcast with Matt Manowak where we recorded, we interviewed him and stuff. It's kind of cool. It was at the time in June, which when we did this, I kind of realized that, look, I knew that I have a team of people that I can count on and kind of like put to do some great things together. In a sense, it wasn't just about me running this alone, my own anymore. There's a group of people that I can count on and they can basically help me do stuff. And I thought this is probably a good time to try and expand our capabilities. And one of the ways I thought we could do this was to do a conference. At first, when I thought about doing a conference for PHP, I was like thinking maybe I just do one for Singapore lah. Don't need to think too far. Then Lawrence Putra, my good friend, he kind of like poked me and said, "Hey, look, dude, just do an Asia-wide one. Just go Asia. Just don't just focus on Singapore. Just go Asia." So okay, think big, right? Let's go. So in September, we did the PHP conference Asia. How many of you guys were there? First year, yeah, awesome. So this is a whole bunch of us. The creator of PHP came down. I emailed him and he said yes, which is for me, I was like, oh, I can do this. Yes. So it was quite epic in a way when he came down. And unfortunately, he came to Singapore at a time where the haze was quite heavy, so he took a lot of photos of hazy Singapore. Embarrassing, but I'll get him back again and we'll make sure we have clear skies, right? Indonesia? Anyway, so yeah, it was the first time that we organized a conference like this, and we had a lot of people coming from all different parts of the world. I even introduced them to some of local cuisine. And here's Rasmus again. We also had students from ITE. We're very student friendly. We want more people to come and join us and even join this, make ITE a career. So basically, we want to encourage students to join us. And I gave a whole bunch of free tickets out to ITE, to Singapore Poly. I did give some tickets to them. Yeah, probably this year, if we do it again, probably do the same thing. Because we want to encourage as many of these young people to come forward and learn about the industry and what we do. I also felt that at the time that we needed to start some form of women's movement, because it seems to be the coolest thing to do right now. All the different user groups are doing like Rails Girls la, Pi Ladies la. PHP developers who are female are strong people, right? And they're not ladies, they're women, right? Anyway, and this is the first photo we took. Quite a few of you are here. Thank you for coming. Of course, last year we did another conference, a bit smaller, but that was the first year we tried to do like a tutorial day. Because first year we did this, I wasn't sure what we're doing, so I kind of like just did talks without any workshops. And last year we actually did a one-day workshop before the talks. So that turned out to be very successful. Amazon came in and sponsored the rooms. It was like three different rooms and they were all fully packed. I was like, my God, yes, that was cool. Yeah, so we had speakers coming from all parts of the world. The guy in the orange t-shirt, his name is David Shafiq. People who knows about the Zen certification program will be familiar with him. He basically wrote a textbook that we read to pass our exam. It was kind of symbolic for me because when I passing the Zen certification exam was kind of like my entry point into making this a serious career. As in, I really want to do this for real. I really want to share be serious about the craft, about this what we're doing. So when I read his book and I was able to pass the exam because I read his book, for me it was kind of like, it was a very important moment for me when he came and I could tell him about what he has done in my life. So it's kind of cool. Yeah. Same as the year before when Rasmus was in the audience and I kind of like, you know, hey, because of you, I have a career, I have, you know, all that stuff. Kind of cool, you know. Anyway, it was also that day, that around that time that our president, S.R. Nathan, passed away. So we also did like a moment of silence for him. Anyway, yeah, more photos, yay. And because we had a lot of people coming from different parts of the world, we also wanted to get them to mingle. So I did a little game where I got everyone taking photos together. Make sure you meet with somebody who is of a different continent from where you're from and take a photo with them. So it's kind of cool. Of course, we also had the PhD women who was started then. I think April was quite instrumental in putting that together. So it's kind of cool. So what's next? Probably we'll have another conference this year. hopefully, fingers crossed. Hopefully we'll have more meetups and more speakers to come forward, hopefully. More co-organizers. I can't do this alone. Please help me. And of course, hopefully new leadership to come forward and bring this to the next bring this to the next lab. So yeah. I'm not going away soon, so I'll still be here. So yeah, but hopefully I'll have more people coming forward. So
biggest mentor.
What? Yeah, don't want to say it like that la. Thank you. Anyway, yeah, so that's all I have. Any questions? No? Yeah. So anyway, thank you all for this 10 years. I think it's really great that we have I've seen so many familiar faces coming from way back then, and here is still with us, and many new faces, which I think I'm very thankful for, and I think hope we can continue to grow this community. Yeah, that's all I have. Thank you. Oh, you have a question?
Yeah, I asked a question, right?
Yeah.
Since you've gone through 10 years of this PHP thing, how do you see PHP as relevant today versus 10 years ago when we first started?
I think as long as there's a web server running around, it will probably be running PHP.
Perl is still.
Well, yeah, also that's also true. Perl is still running. Yeah. So I guess as long as someone needs a website, and probably and there'll probably be people who can do it in WordPress, and people can do it in other frameworks, and probably can. I think in many parts of Asia, especially, there are more PHP developers than other languages out there. So I think it's still very good opportunities, especially with the new releases of PHP, PHP 7, and HHVM. PHP can basically is on par in terms of performance with a lot of other languages out there. Actually, we outperform a lot of other languages in many aspects. Yeah. I think it's the shortest route from getting from A to Z. You know, we want to get a website up, write a few lines of code, da-da. You know, in Ruby, you got to like, gem install, do this, do that. You know. Or Python, you got to like, pip install, blah, blah, blah. And they can't scale. Oh, okay. Out of the box, they can't scale, but PHP can. So, yeah, which is cool. Yep. All right, great. So that's all I have. Thank you. And next up, Zion.